when you come to an end, it is nice to grow old gracefully.
Many human beings hope to reach an age of 70 or more years, but some insects live for only a few days. And there are certain microbes which go through all their living, growing and reproducing in just a few short hours. Well, the yeast cells used in bread making are microbes which grow very rapidly. This block of yeast contains more than 1,000 million yeast cells, tiny little plants, too small to see individually, but when magnified 100 million times with an electron microscope, a yeast cell looks like a miniature football, and it works like a tiny but very efficient factory, taking in sugar and changing it to alcohol and carbon dioxide, which is a gas, and releasing energy. Well, when a yeast cell is active, it grows to a certain size, then it forms a little bud on one side. This bud is a new yeast cell, and it grows rapidly all the time, acting like a second factory, until it's as big as the first yeast cell. Then this new yeast cell may form a bud, and the original cell may form a second bud, and so a chain of yeast cells quickly grows. In bread making, yeast cells are mixed with flour, salt, powdered milk, fat, and water in a giant mixing machine. In this particular batch, 8.5 kilograms of yeast are used. That's more than 8,000 million yeast cells, alive and ready to grow. The machine is controlled by knobs and gauges, indicating mixing speed, temperature, and time. And after a few minutes, the machine is opened, and a smooth, sticky mixture emerges, the dough. The dough is then transported to another machine, where it's chopped into pieces. And these pieces can be moulded into various shapes, depending on whether the final bread is to be a loaf or a roll. In this case, rolls are being formed, and the yeast cells are already growing and reproducing. The rolls are placed on trays, ready for the prover, where the yeast cells in the dough continue to grow very rapidly because of the high temperature and humidity. Thousands of carbon dioxide bubbles are produced, so the dough increases in size. It rises. The rolls are next placed in the oven, where the bubbles expand, the yeast cells die, the alcohol evaporates, and a beautiful crust forms on the outside. That's how bread is made in a large, modern bakery. Bacteria or germs are tiny little microbes, so tiny that you could fit 1 million of them on the head of a pin. And if you look at a single bacterium magnified 50,000 times with an electron microscope, it may look like a sausage with hairs. And bacteria are all around us. Some cause disease, but others carry out the vital work of changing dead organisms into useful material in the soil. And bacteria grow very, very rapidly. When conditions are right, a single bacterium may form a wall across the middle. And then these two halves may pull apart until there are two separate bacteria. The whole process takes only about 20 minutes. Well, let's see what happens if this growing in number continues. We'll use a calculator to help us work it out. One bacterium can multiply itself by 2 in 20 minutes. So after 20 minutes, we have 2 bacteria. Now, let's imagine that after another 20 minutes, each of these bacteria multiply by 2. So we have 4 bacteria. That's after 40 minutes from the start. After 60 minutes, or 1 hour from the start, we have 8 bacteria. So every hour, we get 3 multiplications. So after the second hour, 1, 2, 3, we'll have 64 bacteria. After the third hour, 1, 2, 3, 512 bacteria. After the fourth hour, that many. Fifth hour, that many. After 6 hours, that many. After 7 hours, that many. After 8 hours, more than 16 million bacteria, all growing from the original cell. That's really growing. Microbiologists are often concerned with growing bacteria in large numbers. The bottle on the left contains no bacteria, the one on the right contains 1,000 million. When handling bacteria, a microbiologist often uses a wire loop which has been sterilized in a flame. This is to get rid of any unwanted bacteria so that he can be sure he's handling pure bacteria. The bacteria can be grown on solid food, like this special jelly. in a little dish containing sugars and proteins and salts. The bacteria are spread out with the sterilized wire loop, and a single bacterium can produce overnight a shiny round spot or colony containing 10 million bacteria. This dish contains lots of those colonies, and each of those bacteria will be exactly like the original germ. At the Microbiology Department of the University of Adelaide, bacteria are grown in a batch processor, a complicated machine which provides bacteria with the ideal conditions for growing and multiplication. A small number of bacteria are added to a special soup or broth containing a lot of food, and this mixture is poured in through the top of the machine. And then the machine is sealed, and air is bubbled through the mixture from the base, and the mixture is stirred very rapidly, and it's kept warm with lamps. The bacteria multiply at an incredible pace. Bacteria are needed in large numbers to do microbiology research and find out about disease, about food and drugs, and about growth and inheritance. And with this machine, it's possible to start with one bacterium and end up with 5,000 million million bacteria, just like the first one, after only 3 days. That's growing at an incredible pace. Dr. Reeves, what is a microbiologist?
Lots of microbiologists work on bacteria which cause disease, identifying them. Others work on bacteria which are of interest because they are involved in cheese production or yogurt production. Others work on bacteria which are of interest for agricultural reasons or which are important in studying water control.
If you think yeasts and bacteria can grow rapidly, wait till you hear about viruses. Viruses are even smaller than bacteria, and they attack other living things. This one has been magnified about a million times, and it attacks bacteria. It has a head which looks a little bit like a hexagon from the side, a hollow tail, and a long thread of something called nucleic acid, which is normally packed inside the head. And a virus works something like a spy. Imagine a spy sneaking into a jam factory with secret plans. It takes over the factory and changes the machinery so that the factory now produces new spies instead of jars of jam, and the new spies go out and attack other factories. That is what a virus does. It may attack a bacterium, inject its nucleic acid into the cell, and then the nucleic acid acts like a secret plan. It takes over the bacterium and makes it produce new viruses. And all this can occur very rapidly. Within 12 minutes, the bacterium may burst open to release 50 new viruses. Let's see how rapidly the numbers will increase using our calculator. Well, if one virus particle multiplies itself by 50, after 12 minutes, we may have 50 virus particles. And then after 24 minutes, each of those 50 will multiply by 50 and we'll have 2,500. After 36 minutes, this many. After 48 minutes, that many. And after 60 minutes or 1 hour, there'll be more than 300 million virus particles. No wonder we come down with virus diseases such as colds and flu very rapidly. Within a few hours, we might have billions of them attacking our cells. But fortunately for us, our bodies have defense forces which wage war on the viruses which attack our cells. And our defense forces usually win. We get better in a few days or weeks after the initial crisis.
In my mind, past the love I left, the love I left.